my friend Matt Rooney. Matt is a lawyer and the editor of the Save Jersey blog. And Matt wrote an article about the priest, the Catholic priest in Little Ferry, who's in trouble for allegedly pointing an antique musket at an 8-year-old boy. Hey, Matt, welcome to New Jersey 101.5.
Good morning, Bill. Good to talk to you.
Yeah, you too. So just give me the quick, I only got a couple of minutes, but I wanted to hear from you. You wrote this article essentially saying that this father, Kevin Clark, is a martyr of sorts.
Yeah, look, you know, when you're a Catholic, right, Bill, and I think, you know, you and I share a Christian faith.
Yep, I'm a Catholic.
You know that part of your life as a Christian is that sometimes you have to put up with people that don't agree with your values. Sometimes you're going to be persecuted for it. Now, this is not religious discrimination, but it's a discrimination of a different sort. We have this gun culture in New Jersey, an anti-gun culture, which penalizes innocent people. Like, yeah. Father Carter, like Shaneen Allen, like so many others, which you've talked about on your show and we've talked about at SaveJersey.com.
Yeah.
But still, Newark and Camden and our urban centers are still the Wild West. Why is that? It's because we have extremely misplaced priorities in this state.
Now, let me ask you, as an attorney, Matt, and I agree with you, and for Father Clark, you know, what do you think, as an attorney, the chances he's going to get off? I think the prosecutor's got to drop these charges. It seems ridiculous. If you go after this priest, even if he did what they say there that he did, which is being denied, even by witnesses and parishioners saying there's no way that happened. But even if it happened, wouldn't this now call into question every Civil War reenactor in New Jersey?
Well, that's exactly right, Bill. And I mean, you've highlighted how ridiculous this is, right? We're once again criminalizing non-criminals. So what do? Unfortunately, the way the law works in New Jersey is so many of our gun laws are strict criminal liability laws, or they require some kind of mandatory minimum sentence. So a prosecutor or a judge doesn't always have the leeway to be able to step in and say, you know what, this event happened, but because of the circumstances, it's ridiculous to actually prosecute the person for this. We saw this acutely in the Shaneen Allen case, a mom who was just defending herself with a weapon. She wasn't discharging it. She just had it in New Jersey because it was on her while she was going to set up for her kid's
birthday. She had a legal license to carry in Pennsylvania.
Right, and she ended up needing a gubernatorial pardon. And guess what? She's still out of work because even though she got a pardon, she still has an arrest record. So it's hard for her to get a job. So this is what we do to people here in New Jersey. We don't allow people to act with common sense, and common sense should always be at the heart of justice.
I agree.
At least that's what I always thought.
I agree with you, Matt. Real quick, in 30 seconds, just tell me what... do you think, I said this comment yesterday or 2 days ago, I've been talking about it all week, it's driving me nuts that this priest is being prosecuted, it's so outrageous, but I said, why didn't the prosecutor do the due diligence before he brought charges? I mean, I why do you have to indict someone immediately and go after and prosecute them immediately if you're now, all this other evidence is coming out? Isn't there a window that these guys go and do some research first?
Yeah, you would think, and listen, I don't want to climb inside this prosecutor's head because I don't know him. However, I think sometimes they're looking for headlines. I think sometimes it comes from a more innocent place. We have a situation with a young boy, right?
Yeah.
And they don't want to be accused of letting a potentially dangerous situation continue or perpetuate without them acting. Because then if somebody gets killed and there wasn't a prosecution, then it's on the prosecutor, right? But again, I think when you are a public official in an important office like that of a prosecutor, you have to use your head. You have to use common sense because you're called to help administer justice. And when you divorce that from common sense, Bill, you get ridiculous results and you're not defending the people anymore.
I'm with you. All right, Matt Rooney, thank you very much for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Have a great weekend. I'm sure we'll be talking next week.